day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another fun, fast laser project. So let's get cracking. Friends, today I am giving you a project that you can play with. This is a laser cut car that a student of mine created and then we have modded ever since. It is built on a simple premise. We have got 4mm thick cardboard, so you'll notice if I ungroup this part right here and do F to fit view, this is 4mm thick, and then we cut in holes that are also 4mm wide. That way it's pretty easy to assemble once you've got it laser cut. I'm gonna click home so we can see it all. After we built all our pieces, you can see this is how it assembles. There are tabs that hold everything together. We use straws like you would get from McDonald's. While you're assembling it, of course, I just did a duplicate. I do want to show you this real quickly. I'm going to do C for cruising. I'm going to set this back on the ground. And what I want to show you is how magic this cruising is. When I click on this and I grab one of the handles, I can drop it right on that wall. It used to be a two-step process. Now, because of cruising, you can just instantly get the parts where you need them while you're trying to assemble your future project. So friends, let me show you how to send it to a laser cutter, and then we'll take it outside and we'll cut it. So first I'm selecting only the parts, not the car. Then I'm going to choose export, and since we're going to do a laser cut, we're going to do a SVG. I've got a folder dedicated to my 3D modeling projects. I'm going to simply hit save and let's head out to the laser cutter. All right, friends, let's start by getting our cardboard aligned. This is 4mm thick cardboard. This is my fastening system I have created. These are wires that you use for hanging insulation. And then I have got washers that hold them down tight so I can get my material in place. The laser still works around it just fine, and it's pretty darn slick. Before I power the laser on, let's get the height right. Friends, I have come up with a strategy where I take three of these little pieces and I put them underneath. I loosen it, then I take our guide, line it up, tighten it up, and you'll notice when it tightens, it's pretty snug. But now you can hear that it's under there and it's just right. Once again, I love that we can store that right there. Friends, we are doing our cutting in Lightburn. I'm going to start a brand new project. I'm going to just hit plus. I did not have to save that last one because I had already completed it. I am going to use the laser man, but I'm not going to turn it on till later because it's a little noisy. And then friends, we are going to simply import our project. Remember, I stored it in the 3D modeling. After a moment, there you can see my laser cut car appears. I am going to rotate this 90 degrees. While it is all selected, I'm just going to hit 90 and press enter. This will fit better on my cardboard. Let's zoom in and take a look and see if we see any errors. Everything looks exactly how I want. So now we just got to see if it fits on the laser. Friends, let's power on the laser. And of course, it connects. I'm going to switch to move. I'm going to do a shift nudge to get it out a little bit and a shift nudge to get it over. Making sure I'm on my cardboard, I can come back a couple clicks. And friends, let's hit frame and see if this project fits on my cardboard. Oh, check it out. That is pretty darn magical. Now the important part, friends, we need to check our cuts and layers. I am using 600 for my speed. Notice there are lots of little parts here that are close together, so I want to make sure that they don't flame up. I'm going to remind you, make sure you stay with your laser. I'm going to try two cuts, a power of 100. And of course, friends, I am grabbing my safety glasses and let's make something magical. Thank you. Alrighty friends, so there after less than 20 minutes, we have it cut out. I will remove the wire so I can get this cardboard out of here. And let me show you what we made. Check it out, they are popping out just like you'd expect. I'll get all those parts out and about and let me show you how to assemble. Alright friends, so it is time to do some assembly. Tell you, make sure you punch out all the holes, and we're going to do the wheels first. Now of course there's four wheels and we double them up. I always use tacky glue. I will say again and again and again, less is more. That way things dry faster, especially if you're doing this in a classroom. Bingo. And then simply add the second wheel on top. Make sure they are lined up. I have got some straw pieces that we do use for axles. I'm gonna just leave those in there to make sure that they stay the way they're supposed to while they dry. Next, you need to find the undercarriage and the four axle holders. Friends, there are two styles. There is the thicker one and the thinner one. The thicker one goes in the front. Same rules with glue, less is more. I'm gonna put a little on both sides. And they just slide in like that. This is part of that 4mm groove technology we put in because of the cardboard. Then of course we do the same thing in the back. Little glue, little glue, little glue, little glue. And then we can slide those underneath. Note that hole up there shows us where the front is on our chassis. With those in place, we can add this part. Once again, we're doing glue here and on that little edge. You can also put a little on the insides. Once again, the larger piece goes to the front and it sets right in that groove. If you give these a little bit more time to dry, that makes it a little easier. But I'm going to do it quick because I got other things to do today. Other side, grabbed, glue, and a little bit of glue, and a little bit of glue, and a little bit of glue. And it sits just like that. Find your hood. It's got the fancy holes in the front. And it is going to glue on top of all four of these. Once again, a little bit of glue, a little bit of glue, and a little bit of glue. This will help give this a little bit of strength as well. And drop it right in place. You can also find the roof at this point. Notice it's the one with the sunroof. It glues on the same type of way. This time I'm gonna put the glue up here. And once again, it matches that exact same width. And then back here is the trunk. Notice the tabs go to the back. I'm gonna put the glue on top of these axles. And once again, as this all starts coming together, I'll put a tad there as well, and a tad there. It starts to become more rigid. And with those all lined up, I'm going to give it a few moments to dry before I move on to the next parts. So it is dry enough that I was able to lay it on its side. Now I'm going to find the side panel. Notice, do find one that's not printed on. Make sure you double check ahead of time. That's going to work out fantastic. You can see how that lines up right there to once again lock this all together. I'm going to add glue along this one, along this one, a little back here, of course up in the front, and then a tiny bit down here and here as well. Nothing in the middle because that is an open area. And then just make sure they all line up. Once you've got that dried, you can switch it to the other side. Tacky glue is super awesome because of how quick it does get tacky. I'm gonna take these axle straws and I'm gonna just push them through there to make sure I keep my wheels lined up. That's a slick trick as well. And then friends, we need to glue the other side on. A little bit of glue along here and here, and of course along the back end. And then just a tiny bit down here and down here. Make sure you've got the front to the front. And bingo, it's starting to look like a Jeep. And at this point, it's even pretty sturdy. Friends, make sure you give it some time to dry and then slide your front end in right there. And then in front of that, we add the signature Jeep headlights. Make sure you get the side that did cut out the best. And bingo, you have got a sweet Jeep front end. Spin it around, and then we need to add the back. Of course, it just slides on. Once again, a little glue, and a little glue. And let's fix it in place. How cool is that? Friends, the final step is the axle. You'll notice I made these about as wide as the car. We fasten these with hot glue, so of course make sure you're careful with the hot glue. And then the technique we use is we simply push the straw through so that it's poking out the wheel. Of course, you do have to wait a moment for it to heat up, but when it does heat up, make sure you do not get hot glue on your fingers. Just put it on the outside and, like I said, let it cool. Once it is cool, you can slide it through the axle hole. And then if you push from the outside, it's easier to get a wheel on there. Once again, notice I cut that to the width of it, and I'm just putting glue on the outside of the straw. And then I can pull the wheel out into the glue. And once again, let it cool so it locks in place. You never get any glue on your fingers, which is fantastic, and your wheels generally spin pretty well. So once again, a little bit of hot glue out here on the outside. Make sure that hot glue is in there and let it cool. Note, I am being patient off camera, letting it cool. And then once again, you can finish it. This time I'm going to grab the middle of the straw. That's another safe place to hold it. And put a little bit of glue out here on the end of the straw. And pull the wheel into it. Give it a couple spins and let it cool. Wheels are looking straight, they're lined up, and now it's time to add the doors. Alright, so those have cooled off so I can set them down. Notice if you hadn't, they would stick to the wood. And it's time to add our doors. We've got bent doors and we've got straight doors. Straight ones go here, bent ones go here. There's my straight one. Drop it in place. And here's a bent one. Notice I do need to make sure I pop out the little window. And then we need to do the same thing on the other side. Little glue, little glue, bent door, and the straight door. Friends, just like that, we have got an awesome little Jeep. Friends, there you have it. A laser cut cardboard Jeep designed in Tinkercad. Has that sweet Jeep front end. Totally rolls using straws you can snag from McDonald's and normal 4mm cardboard. A design inspired by an 8th grader, completely created in Tinkercad, and as you can see, fun, fantastic, and free. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HL ModTech. Of course, friends, don't forget you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HL ModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.